Hello class, we are going to start our class of math today. So good morning everyone. We are going to start by praying, okay? So close your eyes and bow your heads. Everybody please, let's pray in this morning. Dear Jesus in heaven, we thank you for a new day of life. Thank you for the fresh rain that was falling over us this morning. Thank you for all your blessings. Thank you because so far you have been a protector with us. In this morning, we ask you especially for Natalie. She's getting better. We ask you to complete healing her. Also, we ask you for Joseph's uncle. If it is your will, let him recover completely. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, guys. So today we are going to have something different. Today we are going to make first a little review of three topics that we have been learning about days ago, and after the review we are going to start a topic in which we are going to use calculators. So you are going to need your calculator only for today, okay? But first we are going to do the review, and let me place the board. Okay, there we have it. And what we are going to have first is a, let's write review. So take your notebooks and write this one, review. And the first topic that we are going to review is remaining number okay. Do you have it? If you can see that here we have a mixed number. Remember that a mixed number has a whole number and a fraction. So in here we have to change or to rename this mixed number into a fraction. So let's remember what do we have to do. If we want to change this into fraction, what do we have to do?
To multiply to... Ah, sí, como...
To multiply, yes, what? 8 times?
5 and add the 2.
And we have to add number 2. Excellent, so let's do it. 8 times 5?
40 plus 2?
16.
Let's see.
8
times 42. 42.
40 plus 2. 42.
42.
42 what?
42. 5.
42 feet. Okay. So. In here, we have improper fractions. The mixed number proper fraction. Okay?
¿Quieren ver mis panqueques?
Okay, so I need you to copy this. The title, this subtitle, and this example. Jose Daniel, do you have it? I need you to copy this. And also Santiago, Nayeli, all of you, please copy this in your notebook, because then I'm going to erase and continue with other examples.
Okay, miss. Wait me a moment, please. Wait me a moment. Mommy, wait. Wait, miss. Erase me.
Do all of you already have this?
No, miss.
Did you finish, guys?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So now write renaming improper fractions. Now the other topic is renaming improper fractions. Do you have it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now I need you to pay attention to remember, because you already saw this topic. To remember, what do you have to do? Here you have an improper fraction, and now you have to change this into a mixed number or into a whole number. So what do you have to do?
To divide.
Excellent. We have to divide 20 divided by 3. What can you multiply here in the quotient by 3? That's going to be 20 or less than 20.
6.
Okay. Let's try with 6. 6 times 3, 18. And 20 minus 18? 2, right? So, which one is going to be my whole number?
Number 6.
Excellent. Number 6 is going to be my whole number.
See the Rafael 6, 2, 3.
Which one is going to be my numerator?
2.
Number 2, this one that is in here.
Three.
And the denominator is going to be number 3. Okay? In this case, guys, we cannot simplify the fraction, so this one is the answer. But always we have to see if the fraction can be simplified. If the fraction can be simplified, you have to simplify. But in this case, this one is the answer. Okay? So I need you to copy this example, please. Do you have it?
No.
Did you finish?
No.
Excellent. Valeria says she already finished. What about the others? Did you finish?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So,
yes.
With the same topic, I will do another example for you to remember something very important. With the same topic, don't erase the topic. Just another example. What about if I have, for example, here 28, and in here I have 4. You have to do the same. You have to divide 28 by 4. What number can you multiply by 4? That is going
to be 7.
Or close to 28. 7.
7.
7 times 4?
28.
So, looking here, guys, because some of you were doing this example incorrect. When you have 0 in that remainder, the only number that you are going to write here is the whole, only 7. No.
Okay.
This one doesn't have fraction. Why? Because it was exact. La división fue exacta. Cuando la división es exacta y tengo 0 en el remainder, solo coloco el whole number. And that's all. 28 entre 4 es 7 without remainder. Do you understand this?
Yes.
Daniel, Joseph, do you understand?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah.
Remember, if you have 0 here in the remainder, just write the whole number. Okay, copy this example and tell me when you finish.
Finish, means.
Okay. The others, did you finish?
No.
Yes.
No.
Okay, Gloria. Did you finish?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So I'm going to erase.
Yes.
And now we are going to write another topic. This one is the last one. And then we are going to the new topic. Writing. Quotients. Mixed numbers. Okay, write this one. And the example we are going to do is this. Do you have this one, guys?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So now I need you to stop writing and just pay attention to this example. This is a common division that you already have to know how to do. Okay? So what we are going to do is to divide. And how many numbers do you have here? One, two. Yes or no? So you are going to take two numbers from here. One and two. But can you divide 62 by 75? Yes or no? Guys, I need you, Jose Daniel, pay attention to me, please. Stop writing and to pay attention to this example. Can you divide 2 by 75? Yes or no?
No.
No, because this one is less than this one. This one has to be greater than this one for you to be able to divide. So you are going to take one, two, three numbers, and you are going to say 620 divided by 75. What number can you write in here that you can multiply by 75 and it's going to be 620 or less than 620? Let's use our trick. Vamos a usar nuestro pequeño truco porque no nos sabemos la tabla del 75. Entonces, voy a tomar por ahorita solo el 7. Y de aquí voy a tomar, no puedo tomar el 6 porque es menor que el 7. Entonces voy a tomar el 6 y el 2. Solo por ahorita para investigar qué número va aquí. Ahora sí. What number can you multiply by 7? It's going to be 62 or close to 62.
Hey.
Guys, what number can you multiply by 7? That is very 62.
Eight.
Okay, let's start with 8. 8 times 7 is 56. Okay, but now we have to multiply 8 times 75. Okay, so let's do it apart. 8 times 75. 75 times 8. 8 times 5, 40. 8 times 7, 56 plus 4, 60. Okay, 60 is very close to 100. It's very close to 620. Are you okay so far? ¿Está bien hasta allí? Are you understanding so far?
Yes.
Okay. So now we are going to subtract 620 minus 600. 0 minus 0, 0. 2 minus 0, 2. And 6 minus 6, 0. What do you have to do now? What do you have to do now with this and these numbers?
Down the 5.
Excellent. You have to bring down number 5. And now you are going to divide 205 by 75. Vamos a usar nuestro truco de nuevo. Por aquí tomo el 7 y por aquí tomo el 20. What number can you multiply by 7 that is going to be 20 or very close to 20? Do you have it? What number can you multiply by 7 that is going to be 20 or very close to 20?
2,
because 3 times 7 is 21, se me pasa. So let's use number 2. Now we have to multiply 2 times 75. So let's do it in here. Or 75 times 2. 2 times 5, 10. 2 times 7, 14 and 1, 15. So we write 15 in here, and then we subtract. 5 minus 0, 5. Now, can you say 0 minus 5? All right. So number 2 becomes 1, and number 0 becomes 10. Because this one ends a unit to number 0. 10 minus 5? 5. And 1 minus 1, 0. Siempre tienen que ir chequeando que lo que les va sobrando no sea mayor que esto. Y así ustedes van corroborando que su división es correcta. Do we have another number that we can bring down?
Yes, the 0.
Okay, so let's bring down number 0. And now we have 550 divided by 75. Vamos a usar nuestro truco de nuevo. Uso el 7 por aquí y uso el 55. What number multiplied by 7 is going to be 55 or close to 55?
8.
6 times, okay, let's.
7.
7, let's use 7. 7 times 7, 49. It's very close to 55. Let's use it in here. Seven times 5, 35. 7 times 7, 49 plus 3, 55.
52.
52. So we have 525. We use it in here, 525. And then we subtract. 0 minus 5 is not possible. Number 5 becomes 4 because it lends a unit to 0 and 0 becomes number 10. 10 minus 5, 5. 4 minus 2, 2. And 5 minus 5, 0. Can you continue dividing? Do you have another number in here that you can bring down to continue dividing?
No.
No, right? So, once you have finished your division, you have to write the mixed number here. Which one is going to be my whole number? Which one is my whole number in here?
827.
827. Excellent. What is going to be my numerator?
25.
And then? My denominator, 75. In this case, guys, look at the fraction, 25 and 75. This fraction can be simplified. Solo viendo que ambos terminan en 5, pueden ser divididos ambos por el número 5 o por el número 25 incluso. Let's use 25. So it's going to be 827. Twenty-five divided by twenty-five, one. And 75 divided by 25. ¿Cuántas veces cabe el 25 and 75?
3
times. So in here is 75 divided by 25 is 3. ¿Qué fue lo que hicimos para simplificar? Encontrar un número que los divida a ambos. El 25 divide al mismo 25 y el 25 también puede dividir al 75. Y al final nos queda la fracción simplificada de esta forma. 827 1/3. So now guys, copy this process for you to have it.
Finish, miss.
What about the others?
Finish.
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 Finish. All of you finish?
No.
Yes.
Okay, the ones that are already finished, go and look for your calculator. Because right now we are going to use calculator.
Okay.
Hola. Bien.
Do you finish? Did you finish?
Yes, I don't have the whole.
Yes.
Yes, I.
Tell me. Did all of you finish, guys?
Yes.
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 Okay, so I will erase.
Yes. Yes.
Nayeli, are you here?
Yes, me, I am.
Did you finish, Nayeli?
Yes.
Okay. So, you will erase. And now, guys, I need you to go to page 155. Go to your book. 155, page 155. And the topic is.
Mire, yo lo tengo calculadora.
Okay, you can use the calculator of your cell phone. But first, just pay attention here, because if you use the calculator of your cell phone, you are not going to be able to see the board. Okay, calculator unit prices. That is the topic that we are going to see today. And it's really, really, really easy. And in there we have a problem. So we are going to read the problem. I will ask Rocío, can you read the problem to us, please?
Yes. Okay. Mr. Nordquist is shopping for the best toy in dog food. She used his calculator to find the cost of 1 pound of dog food for each brand. Which brand is the best toy?
Okay, so there we have a lady, Mrs. Nordquist, and she is trying to decide what dog food to buy. And she has 3 options. Happy Dog, she has also Healthy Dog, and Best Dog. You don't have to copy this one because you already have it in your books. So just pay attention. Hay 3 marcas, Happy Dog, Healthy Dog, or Best Dog. Which one of these one do you think is the best choice? Let's see, this one, Happy Dog, how many pounds do you have in one bag? En un saco de the Happy Dog, how many pounds do you have?
Look at seven.
7 pounds. And the price? What is the price?
3 and 8.
Okay. Now let's see for Healthy Dog. How many pounds do you have?
9.
9 pounds. And the 9 pounds cost $3.89. And then we have the Best Dog with how many pounds? 15 pounds. And the price is $6.75. Can you see this information in the picture?
Yes.
Yes, right? So, for you to decide which one is best, Happy Dog, Healthy Dog, or Best Dog, you have to find what is the price for 1 pound. Tienen que encontrar el precio de una libra. Para ver si es más caro, Happy Dog, Healthy Dog, or Best Dog. How do you do that? Okay. So what you are going to do, let's continue reading, and it says, remember. Vamos a leer la parte que dice remember. To find the unit price, we divide the price by the number of units of measurement in the bag. So the lower price is going to be the best choice. So let's do for the first one first. Vamos a hacer a Happy Dog. Voy a dejar esto por acá porque esta información ustedes ya la tienen en el libro, en la imagen. Entonces, vamos a ver cuánto vale cada libra de Happy Dog. Porque aquí tenemos que el SAT, 7 libras vale esto, pero solo una libra valdrá. So that is what we are going to do right now. And it says that you have to complete a code in your calculator. ¿Qué código van a completar en la calculadora? Van a escribir 308. Luego van a presionar la tecla. We are going to press the key of this. That is division. Then you are going to divide it by 7. And then you are going to press the key of equal. Who can tell me the answer in here? 3 and 0, 8 divided by 7. What is the answer?
Five.
You have to write this one in the calculator. 3.08. Press this key, then 7, and then press this key.
I have the answer.
Uh-huh. Tell me.
0.44.
Excellent. 0.44. Okay. So that means that 0.44 means, esto lo tienen en su libro ustedes, 0.44 means 0.44 of a dollar or 44 cents. Son 44 dollars or 44 cents, 44 centavos nada más de un dólar. That is the price of 1 pound of Happy Dog. Okay. Did you complete this one in your books?
Yes.
Okay, so I will erase this. We already know that Happy Dog is 0.44 or 44 cents. 44 cents. Vamos a encontrar ahora para Healthy Dog. Let's see Healthy Dog. And complete the code. Healthy Dog is 3.87 divided by 9 and then equal. Do that in the calculator. 3.87 divided by 9 and then equal. What is the answer?
It is 0.43 minutes.
Excellent. 0.43 or 43 cents. Okay, complete this. Or 43 cents. Okay. 0.43 dollars or 43 cents is the same. So I will erase this. Esto lo tienen en su libro ustedes. Lo único que tienen que completar es la respuesta en decimales y en cents. Entonces, 43. Si solo hubieran estas dos opciones, ¿por cuál se decidirían? ¿Happy dog o healthy dog? Healthy dog, right? Because it's cheaper, es más barata. But we have to find the other one. Best dog. And in best dog, you have to do 6.75 divided by 50, and then the T of equal. What is the answer?
0.45.
Excellent. 0.45 dollars or 45 cents. Okay, so write these two answers in those spaces that you have in your book. And now let's decide. Now we are going to decide because we have to save money, 45 cents. Happy dog is 44 cents, 1 pound. Healthy dog, 43 cents, 1 pound. And best dog is 45 cents, 1 pound. Which one are you going to decide for?
Healthy dog.
Healthy dog. Excellent. So let's answer the problem. The best buy is healthy dog. So write the answer in there, in the last line. The best buy is the brand healthy dog. Okay, do you have? I will erase this and let's do the exercises that we have in this page. Number one says, £5 at, la arroba que ustedes ven ahí significa at. 0.36. A pound. So you are going to write here what is the unit price. 5 libras les cuesta esto. 5 pounds at 0.36. Now, okay, here we have a pound. This price that you have in here is the price of the 5 pounds or the price of 1 pound? Guys, in this example,
1 pound,
because it says 0.36, 1 pound or a pound. Entonces aquí tenemos 5 libras a 36 centavos la libra. Si 36 centavos vale la libra, ¿cuánto será en 5 libras? Do we have to multiply or to divide?
Divide,
multiply.
Vamos a ver. Si, ustedes, si una baleada vale 10 pepinos,
una baleada vale 10 lempiras y ustedes se quieren comer 5 baleadas, van a tener que dividir o multiplicar.
Multiplicar.
Multiplicar. Los 10 lempiras por las 5 baleadas que se van a comer.
Multiplicar.
Lo mismo aquí. 5 libras a 36 la libra. Entonces, solo una libra vale 36 centavos. Para saber cuánto me cuestan las 5 libras, tengo que multiplicar. So, what are you going to multiply? 0.36 times 5 and then equal. What is the answer?
I have 1.80.
Naranjas, melones, sandías. 1.80 what? Naranjas, sandías, dólares, lentes.
Dólares.
Dólares, excelente, dólares. So this one is the answer number one. Let's do number two. Number two says 10 gallons at 0.96 a gallon. Okay. 10 galones, no sé de qué, de gasolina, de mantequilla, de whatever. 10 galones a 96 centavos
Milo.
Galón. So what are you going to do? 96 cents is only 1 gallon, but you have to find the price for 10 gallons. So you have to do the same of here. You have to multiply 0.96 times 10 gallons equals. How many dollars? The 10 gallons.
9.6. 9.6.
10.6 or 60. Okay. 9 and 60. Do you have these two examples? Do you have them? Ok, necesito que tengan esto para que sepan qué fue lo que hicieron. Ah, aquí multipliqué porque me estaban dando el precio de una libra y tenía que encontrar el de 5. Aquí también multipliqué porque me estaban dando el precio de un galón y tenía que encontrar el precio de 10 galones. Ok, ¿may I erase this?
No.
Solo me hacen falta dos, number 3 and 4.
Me.
Uh-huh.
I'm copying this exercise in the notebook.
This, look. Si le cabe en su libro, ponga esto abajito del ejercicio para que se recuerde qué fue lo que hizo. Multiplica 5, porque estábamos encontrando del precio de una libra, cuánto era el precio de 5 libras.
En ese
try to do number 3 and number 4 by yourself. The one that I'll tell you later.
Yes.
May I raise?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So in number three, it says 7 ounces. 7 ounces.
And 52 ounces.
Igual, la onza vale $4.52. Sorry. Ahora tengo que encontrar en 7 onzas cuánto es. Si una onza vale $4.52, ¿cuánto será en las 7? The same, we have to multiply 452 times 7 and then the sign of equal. What is the answer?
Thirty-one and sixty-four. Excellent.
And number four, it's very alike also. 75 pounds at 145 a pound. Vean, chicos, si les dan el precio de una libra y lo que tienen que encontrar es más de una libra, 75 libras, entonces tienen que multiplicar si les dan el precio de una. Igual, en todos estos, número 1, número 2, 3 y 4, tenían que multiplicar porque les daban el precio de una unidad. So, here also you have to multiply 145 times 75 equals
108.75.
Excellent. Who was answering?
Zoe.
Excellent, Zoe. 108.75. 108 and 75. Quiere decir que si usted va a comprar 75 libras de queso, vamos a decir que son queso, y una libra vale 1 and 45, si usted compra 75 le va a costar 108.75. Okay. Do you have it?
Yes.
Okay. Now, guys, quiero explicarles un ejercicio de la tarea porque es diferente a estos. Vamos a la página, let's go to page 156, y este es el último ejercicio que explico, con esto terminamos. 156. Let me
read.
Let's do exercise number one. Number one says 6 pounds of hamburger. Uno estaba diciendo que tenía hambre, ¿verdad? Y nosotros hablando de hamburgers. 6 pounds of hamburger.
Vaya, vaya, presta atención.
Que el audio se lo tomó. At 11:34. You have to analyze, guys. You have to think. It says 6 pounds of hamburger, 11.34. It is telling you the price of 1 pound or the price of the 6 pounds?
6 pounds.
Excellent.
Okay.
No me dice 11.34 a pound. Solo cuando me dice 11.34 a pound, an ounce, a gallon. Pero aquí no me están dando el precio de una libra. Me están dando el precio total. Entonces aquí vamos a hacer lo contrario. Si este es el precio total, en 6 libras, ¿cuánto vale una libra? So, instead of multiplying, now you are going to instead of multiplying, what is the opposite of multiplying?
Divide.
¿Por qué vamos a dividir? Porque ahora me están dando el precio total y tengo que encontrar el precio de una sola libra. By 11, the total price, divided by 6. And then you press the key of equal. So, how many or how much is 11.34 divided by 6?
1.89.
Excellent. $1.89. 1 pound of hamburger, the price is 1.89. The 6 pounds, 11.34. So sometimes you are going to divide, and other times you are going to multiply. When you have the price of 1 pound and you have to find the total price, you are going to multiply. When you have the total price and you have to find the price of 1 pound, so you are going to divide. Do you have any doubt or question? In this one was 156, number one. Your homework is 156 from 1 to 10 and 1 problem solving. Don't forget. Okay? So now you have to do only 9 because I already helped you with 1. And remember, if you do not have a calculator, you can use the calculator of your cell phone only for this topic because it's about calculator, okay? So guys, do you have any questions? Did you understand the topic? Hello, do you understand the topic?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, me.
Yes.
Okay. Did you copy this?
Yes.
Solo déjenme entonces pasarles la lista. Y vaya pasando la lista. Sí. Puede irse saliendo para que comience a hacer sus tareas. Vamos a ver. Amy. Okay. Jasmine.
Presente.
Okay. Kenia.
Present.
Meredith. Is Meredith here? No, right? Nayeli.
Present.
Natalie. Are you here, Natalie?
Nope.
Okay, Rocío.
Present.
Sharon. Sharon was here. Sofía.
Present.
Valeria.
Present.
Zoe.
Present.
Axel. Okay, Axel is here, but I cannot listen to him. Are you here, Jared? Okay, Camilo.
Present.
Carlos Daniel. Cristian Fernando.
Present.
Daniel Martínez. Is Daniel here? Okay. José Daniel.
Present.
Joseph.
Present.
Kevin.
Present.
And Santiago.
Present.
Okay, guys, so this was all for today. So we are going to end the meeting and you can continue with the other classes and with your homework, okay?
Okay.
Bye. Happy to see you.
Bye.
Have a nice day.